We'll get you out of here on a, I guess, a rapid fire. What happens in the offseason question pertaining to three players? Van Vliet, Ibaka, Gasol. How many of those return to the Raptors next year? How do you see their situations playing out as free agents?
Well, as you guys know, there's so many moving parts right now based upon the pandemic with regard to cap situation for everybody in every sport. I would say Marc Gasol would be, I'll be surprised. He struggled. I look at Serge Ibaka, the guy had the best year I've seen in his professional career. A lot's going to depend on number and term, but if you can work out something with him that's relatively short term, even if the number's a little higher, I think you go with it. I think a guy like Fred VanVleet, he has by far proven himself to be a starting professional guard in the NBA. There's no doubt. And not only a starting guard, but a starting guard on a winning team. He impacts winning. You know, everyone looks at offense. The guy's a great defender, not only on ball, but off ball. He's a terrific, terrific player in that regard. And then, you know, he's a really good shot maker. He still struggles when he goes against athleticism, length, and size, scoring at the rim. That's a bit of a concern. You got to surround him with people that are going to spread the floor so he's got space to get his shot off when he gets to the basket. There's not as much congestion inside when he goes there. But in my opinion, if it's a deal that makes sense for both sides, I would love to see him back. I'm a huge fan of Fred VanVleet, and not only from his time in Toronto, but his time at Wichita State. He was just a big-time player and one of the most – you know, everyone talks about Kyle Lowry and how underrated he is. I think if you look at Fred VanVleet from his freshman year at Wichita State – to where he is now as a professional athlete, the guy has, in my opinion, exceeded everything. And I think, you know, as much as he bettered himself, I think if you're the Toronto Raptors or if you're a team out there, I think, again, you talk about Siakam, I think he's a high-character guy that I have a lot of respect and admiration for, that I've been around and watched him. I think he's a true pro that you want in a room with you. Again, a lot's going to depend on the economics and how things work out, but I'm hoping he stays in Toronto because he's a joy to watch.
Yeah, I hope so too. I think it's imperative they make that happen.